Now, an update on the doctor who had trouble balancing his role as a GP and his allegiance to the exclusive Bretheren. Dr. Mark Craddock is an elder of the controversial cult, and after we looked into his practices, the medical board started its own investigation. And Jackie Quist has the result.
It was the night we were head-to-head with the fundamentalist Christian sect, the Exclusive Bretheren.
That was a watershed moment for me. Up until that point, I still felt some sympathy for the church.
Church members tailgating and stalking us across Sydney after we dared question Bretheren elder Dr. Mark Craddock.
You prescribed Ciprostat to a healthy young 18-year-old male who is not a sex offender.
It's at his own request.
Dr. Craddock had prescribed the chemical castration drug Ciprostat to then-teenaged Exclusive Bretheren member Craig Hoyle in a bizarre bid to cure his homosexuality.
He asked for some help.
What are the side effects of these drugs? Blood clots? Depression? Anxiety?
I can't go into all this.
Craig Hoyle was seventh-generation Bretheren, born into the cult. He was excommunicated at age 18 for being gay, cut off from his entire family and the only life he'd ever known, but only after he was sent to Dr. Craddock for treatment.
There's no doubt in my mind that Dr. Craddock was acting under the orders of the church. I saw Dr. Craddock at the instruction of Bruce Hales, the world leader of the church, and his specific words to me was that there's medication you can go on to treat homosexuality.
Now, 3 years later, justice for Craig. The New South Wales Healthcare Complaints Commission prosecuting Dr. Craddock before a medical standards committee. The now 75-year-old doctor found guilty of professional misconduct, severely reprimanded and banned from ever practising as a GP, although he is still allowed to practise radiology.
I'm happy with the decision they reached. I would have liked more of an acknowledgement of how much Dr. Craddock was being influenced by the church and medical decisions that he was making.
This was very gutsy on Craig's part, and I think it's also empowered other people to come forward. It makes the point that no organisation is so big and so powerful that it can't be held to account.
Independent Senator and cult battler Nick Xenophon.
Whenever an organisation has a tax-free status, it's effectively being subsidised by every Australian taxpayer, and because of that, it needs to be accountable, it needs to be transparent, and it needs to be responsible for any damage it causes to individuals.
In 2004, Dr. Craddock was officially reprimanded for prescribing antidepressants by phone to a distressed Bretheren woman. Dr. Craddock now conceding he should never have prescribed Ciprostat to Craig, agreeing he'd prescribed too much without considering the possible side effects. He is now only allowed to prescribe medication to his radiology patients.
This is a victory in that respect. It's a huge comfort to me to know that no one else will be put through what I was put through.
Craig has now rebuilt his life outside the sect. He's travelled the world, carved out a successful career in television, and he works with young people, coming to terms with their sexuality.
I'm very happy indeed. I have absolutely no regrets, and given my life over, I would make the same decision to leave the church.